Phones have a back cover to protect the internal chip from water and dust. Even a car has a bonnet to protect the inner important machineries from rain and storm. So similarly, we have delicate organs inside a body. So these delicate organs, they need to be protected. So we have an outer layer of tissue known as the skin, which forms the upper topmost part of our body. So the skin forms an outer covering of our body and protects the internal organs from mechanical stress. So the skin is a continuous layer or a sheath of cells. The tissue that forms the skin is known as the epithelial tissue. Now, what is a tissue? Tissue is an accumulation of cells. So epithelial tissue is an accumulation of epithelial cells. So epithelial cells accumulate to form the epithelial tissue, which forms a continuous sheath on our topmost layer of the body to form the skin. Skin protects the underlying organs from mechanical injury. Now, when you get mild cuts, we apply Band-Aid on our skin to protect and cover the cut area. Now, within a few days, this cut area, they heal up. So when you see this cut area has developed new tissue because of the formation of new cells. Now, notice something. This new tissue, which is formed in the cut area, they have a very scale-like appearance, just like the scale-like appearance of a fish. See, they have scale-like appearance like a fish. Because they have a scale-like appearance, this tissue is known as a squamous epithelial tissue. Squamous means scale-like. So this tissue has a scale-like appearance, just like the scales of a fish. So squamous epithelial tissue is squamous in nature. That is, it has a scale-like appearance. Now also notice that these cells are irregularly shaped. See, the shape of this cell is not the same as the shape of this cell. So, squamous epithelial cells are irregularly shaped. Now, notice another thing, that all these cells are compact in nature. That is, they are close to each other, forming a continuous sheath of tissue. So these cells are irregularly shaped and they have a compact nature. That is, there is no space between two cells. Cells are tightly packed to form this tissue. And another feature of this tissue is that they are flat cells. See? These are the individual cells. The upper layer and the lower layer, they are very close to each other. And hence they have a flat appearance. See, these are flat cells because the upper surface and the lower surface are close to each other. So, these cells are flat because the upper surface and the lower surface, see, they are very close to each other. Now, this squamous epithelial tissue provides us with protection. It protects our internal organs from mechanical stress. Apart from this function, it also has another function or another property, that of exchangeability. So substances can diffuse in and out of this tissue. And that is the reason creams and other skin products that you apply on your skin, they diffuse further into the skin and you get the benefits of the skin. Because the skin products or the creams, they diffuse into the skin, because that is one of the characteristics of the squamous epithelial tissue. Now, the skin that is there on our face or on our hands, they have a very supple nature. Now, did you ever wonder why the skin on our palms and on our soles, they have such a tough nature? Why are they so tough? Well, this is because the squamous epithelial cells there, they form a multiple layer. See, they form a multi-layer structure. Now notice the topmost layer. The topmost layer consists of flattened cells. Now flattened cells indicate the lack of cytoplasm and all the cellular organelles. If there are no cellular organelles, the functions of the cells won't be performed, and so the cells are dead. So this layer of the multi-layered structure that is present in your palms and in your soles consists of flattened and dead cells. But these dead cells, they become toughened and hardened, and so they can provide us with protection against mechanical injury. So these dead cells, they become hard and protect us, our feet or our hands, from mechanical injury. Now notice another thing. This layer of cells, they are squamous in nature. That is, they have a scale-like appearance. See, all the cells have a scale-like appearance. Now what about these cells? The shape and the structure of these cells do not resemble the squamous cells. See, they do not have a scale-like shape. They are differently shaped. So there are different types of epithelial cells present in the bottom layers of this multi-layered tissue structure. Since there are so many layers of cell that forms the tissue, it is known as the stratified epithelial tissue. Stratified means multiple layers. So see, there are multiple layers of cells forming a tissue. So this tissue that is present in our palms and in our soles, they are known as the stratified epithelial tissue. Now, if you ask me why cracked soles never smoothen by itself, it is very easy. Well, the cracked sole is nothing but the flattened dead cell layer of the stratified epithelial tissue. The upper topmost cells had been flattened and they were dead because they did not have any cytoplasmic content in them. But those cells had become toughened and were providing providing protection from mechanical injury. Now, this layer is formed of dead cells which cannot divide by itself. They cannot divide to form new cells. So the cracked portion of your legs or your feet remains cracked until a person scrubs it off with a pumice stone. So when a person scrubs it off, he is actually scrubbing the topmost dead layer of cells that forms the stratified epithelial tissue.